With no clarity on the size of Satyam's liabilities and the company's valuations, its stock is on a continuous downward spiral in the equity markets. The stock was trading at Rs. 20 levels on the BSE on Friday morning, down nearly 50% over the previous day's close.
Probably the markets are tending to the view that there may be less and less equity post those liabilities which may remain in the company.
Even in the case of a buyer buying the IT company, equity investors may find that there is not much value left for them in the company as they come after claimants and creditors.
For any potential buyer, the more appropriate way would be to look at the operating business of Satyam and pay an appropriate price for it. And obviously the buyer would try and protect himself from any liabilities coming out of that. And that amount of money will be again available in the classic order of first going to creditors, thereafter going to equity holders, if any. And before that, between the creditors and the equity holders will be all the claimants who would have relied on the company for all its disclosures and everything else.
There is also a debate raging whether the company should be allowed to trade on the bourses at all or not. Kotak says that this exposes the investors to the risk of illiquidity and it is not advisable. The way out, he says, is to come up with a quick financial and administrative judgment.
Therefore, maybe a third-party independent auditor or an accounting firm which the regulators decide to get into and to pore over the books of the company may be one option in front of the regulators.
Kotak suggests that to avoid Satyam-like fiascos in future, India Inc. has to look no further than the Murthy Premji model of corporate governance. For Mint in New Delhi, Tanisha Kulshrest.